Once upon a time, there's a nice lady sitting at her desk. Her desk had a big window that faced a parking lot of a small shopping center where many offices were located. She was looking outside. It's about 8:30 in the morning, and she see this guy come with his car, park his car, and instead of going to his office, he goes to a tree nearby, and he puts his hand in the tree, and he stays there for about 8 seconds. Then she watches him walk and walks in the office. Just go through the door. Then later, at 5 o'clock, right before she goes home, she sees he coming out of the office. She sees him coming out of the office, and he goes right to the same tree, touch the tree, and then he goes back to his car and drives home. Next morning, funny thing, she sees the same thing. She's like, that's interesting. I wonder what's going on here. She sees he does the same thing. He goes to the tree, touch his hand on the tree, the trunk of the tree, and then he goes to his office. At night, same thing happened. Right before he goes to his car, he goes to the tree again. So now she's puzzled. She's wondering, what's going on? Why is he doing that? So that goes 2 days, 3 days, 5 days. Finally, she can help herself. So one of the days, next day, she's just getting ready. I'm going to talk to this guy. I'm going to find out what's going on here. So next day, she's watching. She's paying attention. When the guy parked his car and she sees that he's going right to the tree, she leaves her office and she walks over there really fast. So he spent his 8 seconds or so with his hand on the tree. Right before he goes to the office, she goes, "Sir, excuse me, sir, just a second. Can I talk to you for a second?" He goes, "Sure." She said, "I'm sorry. I hope I'm not bothering you, but I'm so curious. I got a question to ask. See the window over there? I walk over there in their office. And for the last 6 days, the last 5 days or so, I've been watching you. And I noticed that every morning when you come to the office, you park your car and you go to the tree over there and you touch the tree and then you go to your office. And then at night, around 5 o'clock or so, you do the same thing. You go touch the tree before you go to your car. Do you mind if I ask, why do you do that? I'm puzzled. Why do you do that?" The guy looks at her and goes, "You know, I'm glad you asked. No problem, I'd like to share." He goes, "You see, I have 3 wonderful kids, they're teenagers right now, a beautiful wife, and a lot of things going on at home. We have challenges, we have issues, we have stuff, you know, things to do, to take care. And here in the office, I'm a sales manager. I have a lot of challenges, issues to take care, a lot of things to do, and a great team to inspire, to engage. So you know what I do? I learned this. I learned the concept of not mixing things and compartmentalize. So when I come home in the morning, instead of going to the office, I go to that tree over there and I touch the tree. And at that moment, I leave all my issues, my challenge, my worries about my kids, about my home, about what I have to do at home. I live in the tree. So when I go to my office, I'm there present. I don't bring anything from my home to the office so I can be my best for my people. And then when I go home, I do the same thing. I go back to the tree and I leave all the issues, the worries, the challenge of the office and the tree, and I take my stuff back from my home. So when I go home, I am present. I'm with my kids, with my family. I can take care of what's going on at home. This way, I don't mix them up. When I'm home, I'm home. When I'm in my office, I'm in my office. And I don't bring the worries home. I don't bring the worries to my office from home. And that's what I call compartmentalization. It's a strategy, it's a concept that I learned. And my dear friends, and that's what I want to share with you guys today. We have to compartmentalize. We got to separate. When you work, When you play, you play. When you're home at home. When you're in the office, you're in the office. Don't mix them up. And if you are right now in pain, suffering, mourning, with a lot of issues, a lot of setbacks at home, learn how to compartmentalize. Learn how to put in a box, in a place, in a Tupperware, someplace for a while, so you can perform right here at the moment with focus, with clarity at this time. Because if you are having issues at home, challenges at home, the last thing you want is to bring to the office, to bring to your business environment. Because you see, if you have already challenges at home that you have to take care of home, and now you bring to the office, you're gonna have way more challenges at the office. And you don't wanna add a problem on top of the problem, right? So we got to learn how to compartmentalize. We got to learn how to separate and be here in the moment. So if you are having difficult times right now with coronavirus, with riots, or with life, a divorce, or health problem, whatever you're going through right now, darlings, compartmentalize. That's a big skill. That's a wonderful skill to learn. So you can separate, take a break, put them away from now. You're still gonna have it. You're still gonna take care of it. You're still gonna feel it. If you are, you know, mourning, you're still gonna feel it. But do the thing right now to help your family, to help your life, to help your kids, to help your business to grow. Separate, because you need to be able to be a leader when you have to be a leader, be a parent when you have to be a parent, be a top producer when you have to be a top producer. You have to be able to be here now and take care of the now, take care of the moment, so you're not mixing your home problems with the office problems. And also you are able to work on. So it's a skill. So I have clients who tells me, coach, I'm working on it. I am working every day on the skill of compartmentalization, separating, you know, putting my distractions away, putting my worries away, putting my fears and doubt away, or maybe my challenge at home or my challenge in the office. So you can be the very best right now at this moment. So compartmentalize, put away distractions, set your day right with the right skills, the right strategy. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed the story. I hope you are working on your mindset and compartmentalizing your business, your life, so you are present, you are in the moment, you are putting away the worries, the sadness, the fear, the challenge, the setbacks, the frustration, the impatience, whatever it is, put it away and be here now and take care of this moment. Take care of your lead generation, do you follow up? Take care of your value creation right now. Take care of your kid right now. Take care of your the family right now. Whatever it is you're doing, do the right thing at the right time. Compartmentalize, be present, be your best, and I know you are. I know you are working on. So this video for me that I'm doing right now is from the bottom of my heart for my special people. Someone actually asked me, coach, what that means? What compartmentalize means? So thank you for asking. Thank you for doing your best with what you have, but keep working on compartmentalization. Keep working on improving your best. Keep working on doing your best. So sending you my love, sending you strength. Give me here your input, your feedback. What do you do every day to be stronger, to compartmentalize, to be better at what you do? Share with me your strategies. With me, I just keep working on compartmentalization, staying here and now and doing my very best at this time, so I don't mix them up. So sending love. Make sure you guys subscribe here for my channel if you just got here for the first time. And all of my friends, all of my beautiful Jedis here, all my beautiful warriors here, they follow me. I love you to the moon and back. And thank you for being with me here, with me on Facebook and Instagram. So you guys rock. So go rock and roll. Make sure you improve yourself every day and stay strong. Lots of love. Bye.